It reads for verse 3, for what said the scripture? Abraham believed God, and it was counted, somebody shall count it, unto him for righteousness. Didn't do anything, he just believed God, and it was counted unto him for righteousness. Now the Greek word for count is the word logizomai. It's like, I'm about to log your stuff for you. I'm logging it. I'm logging it. Every time you do something worthy, I'm logging it in. And then it also means to give credit to. So you get credit for the stuff you do for God. That's what I always say. Only what you do for Christ will last. He's logging what you do. And now I get credit. God gave Abraham credit just for believing. You may not have a dime, but if it's in your heart, you get credit. Ways. Stuff start counting. It start counting. And you don't take 20, 30 years to be blessed. It's not happening quickly because you understand what counts. It counts. Everything counts. What's your credit for? What's your credit for? Give me some credit. It's your credit. I just said your credit. You can make it count. Now watch this. Luke 15. Luke 15, 21. It reads, and the Son said unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and in thy sight, and I'm no more worthy to be called thy son. But the Father said unto his servants, bring forth the best robe and put it on him. I'm about to, just because this boy done repented, I'm about to let that count. I'm about to give him the best robe, not because he's what he did wrong, but what he did right. What he did right counts. Somebody said it counts. It counts. It counts. It counts. It counts. But the Father said to the servants, bring forth the best robe. See, people understand how he would have been backslide when he get the best robe. But you don't know what counts. Good God Almighty. And they put a ring on his hand and shoes on his feet. He got mad for the women then. And they put a ring on his hand. His spirit is right. Good God Almighty. And bring hither the fatted cow and kill it and let us eat and be merry. For this my son was dead and is alive. And he was lost and is found. And then they began to be merry. Now his eldest son was in the field and he came and drew nigh to the house. He heard the music and the dancing and he called one of the servants. And what's going on in his house? What's going on? And he asked what these things meant. And he said, thy brother is come and thy father killed the fatted cow because he had received him home safe and sound. And he was angry and would not go in. Therefore he came his father out and entreated him. Because God is counting what I did for my faith. I want to use as a title today's message, God keeps using my highest test score. He keeps using my highest test score. He ain't using the score that I messed up. He ain't using the score where I failed the test. He still took Terry, he still took a Lot, he still, and both of them got him in trouble. Good God Almighty. He still messed up with Hagar, but God said, I'm not going to let what your belief is count for your righteousness. Prophet's son said, I'm ready to take all my money, give me my inheritance early, and he blew everything. Both of them messed up. But when you've been a good child, God doesn't count your mess ups, he counts your comebacks. Because God don't count it, my mess ups, he counts my comeback. That's why you're going to another level, because you came back. That's why God's trying to pour out of you, because you came back. I don't care what you did wrong. God said, I'm getting ready to bless your comeback. I'm coming back. number 1, 2, and 3. God counts the amazing and wonderful things you do more than your failures, because it's the amazing and wonderful things that reminds him of himself. Because God is not a failure. He don't identify with failure. That have counted more than anything to put me where I am in God's day. I'm going to give you two of my testimonies, understanding the ways of God. One of them I never shared with anybody. The second one I never told the church, but I'm going to go ahead and share it with y'all so you can understand the ways that God approves to cause us to be blessed. Watch this. My first testimony that really counted was how I served my mother and father as a young boy. As a good child, the way I did everything I was supposed to do without them having to tell me twice. Then when my father died before the age of 12, how I took care of my mother became the man of the house, and I was the fourth child. With my older siblings, I fight my mother over their social security check, over their social security check. You represent, I said, mother, that's your money. You the one married my dad. I didn't marry him. Said, you can have that $700 a month. And when I got a job, I was still giving her money in addition to the other money she had. God said the first commandment or promise, Exodus 20 and 12, honor thy father and thy mother, that thy days may be long upon the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee. So one of the first commandments of promise, when you young people and adults, when we honor our parents, God will attach blessings over your life. You're going to be blessed and exceedingly blessed because you honor your mother and your father. I don't care what they did wrong, get how low down or messed up they may have been, you still, by the sight of God, got to show your respect. God. If you're going to get the blessings of God, because the ways of God says to honor your mother and father. And I says, here's the second thing that counts, but I never share with anybody in the church. I got my book in a row. Happens when I said, this is after. Oh my gosh, she's looking, she's looking. Now, in college, when I was in college with everybody else, was being promiscuous because I received God in my life around 18. My entire college years, I never had sex with anybody. And I said, this is very important, what I'm about to tell you. This is very, very important. Now, a young boy from the hood, when all we knew was fornication. We didn't raise up in a church where they taught us the word. All we knew was fornication. So God reveals the knowledge to me, and I'm like, man, you can be delivered. Wow. You don't have to do these things. I read this in my early 20s. Very important. God said it counts in a major way because it's a greater struggle to overcome crack when you've been on it. It ain't no struggle to overcome crack when you ain't never been on it. It's easier to be crack-free when you ain't never had crack. But it's hard to be crack-free when you done had crack. So when you done had something all your life and you used to something all your life, it's hard to just stop doing something. Man, you was cock strong, but he didn't know I was so cock strong throwing the boxes at FedEx. Very, very important. I'm tied into something. So I won't do what happens when I say a word of deliverance from uncontrollable sexual desires. Man, my senior year, my daughter's mother, my senior year in college, because one of the things about it, when you abstain and you ready to do what's right. Now, I'm about to say this. But years after I wrote Happens About Sex, guess what happened? I lusted after Bathsheba. I got played by Delilah. ate every piece of fruit Eve put in my face. I had a baby by Aaliyah. But when God decided to see which test score he was going to use, he used the test when I took care of my mama when my daddy died. He used the test when I stopped having sex in college when everybody else was. When he decides to use and judge you, good God Almighty, he's going to look at what you went through the hardest. He's going to look at what you gave up the longest. He's going to look and say, baby, I don't know my boy. Watch this, watch this. Tuesday night, I didn't know what I was going to preach on. So Dunn and I was in the office with Nina, and she was talking about college and having to prepare for her ACT. And she said, well, her ACT was talking about the scores, I was talking about the tests, I was saying, get an honor because you got to pass the science and the math and the language and the English and the essays. And she was like, yeah. She said, but some colleges, they accept what you call a super score. I said, now, what's a super score? She said, the super score is no matter how many times you took the test, is they gonna take the high score in math, the high score in English, your high score in geography, your high score in language, and whatever them high scores are, that's what your final score gonna be. So, when the teacher grades your high score, it's called a curve.